Now that you know the basics of navigating using the 3DEXPERIENCE platform, let's take a look at what it would be like to set up course infrastructure for you to run an entire class right on the platform. This infrastructure could include a variety of different items, but we'll cover a couple key important ones. Firstly, a course dashboard. Now, a dashboard could be very useful in just keeping everybody up to date on what's happening in the course. Same with the second item, which we think would be a community, a classroom community where you, the instructors, can interact with your students in real time and have real discussions that everybody can see. Now, those are just a couple examples of how you could utilize some of these tools, though there are far many other options that we encourage you to explore and see what works best for you. But for now, let's just take a look at creating a dashboard specifically for your course. We can go to our dashboard list to create a new empty dashboard. Let's say, for example, our course is Introduction to Mechanical Design. One of the first apps we'll want to include is 3D Drive, our data storage application, which is fully cloud-based and can be synced to any desktop. 3D Drive is perfect for sharing course materials with students. So let's drag and drop this onto our dashboard. And we can rename this tab Course Materials. Now we need a folder to put these files in. So let's create a new folder like such. And we can call it Course Materials. We can then drag and drop files into this folder. And once we've added all the materials we want, then we can grant access to the class. To do so, we can just click the caret on the folder and then click Share. There are many ways to share this folder. Like for instance, we could start adding the names of people we want to add individually, or we can share with an entire group. We will need to set up the group first, so let's go back to the compass under the Collaborative Business Innovator role, and we can click User Groups. Notice that just clicking an app launches it on top of the dashboard, though I could always click the Pin to Dashboard button to add it to this dashboard. We can click the Add New User Group button and then give our group a name. For example, maybe Spring Semester 2020. We can then import a list or just add users individually. User groups will come in handy quite a bit, so we recommend creating at least one group for each class. Though, depending on the way you run your class, it might be useful to create user groups for each team engaged in team and group projects and activities. But for now, all we need is one for the entire class. We can simply type in our users' names to add them to the group. And now we can get rid of our user groups widget and finish sharing our 3D Drive content with the class using the new user group we just created. The user group will also come in handy when our dashboard is complete and we are ready to share it with that entire class. There are many other tools that you might want to take advantage of with your course dashboard. Maybe it would be useful to have a tab on this dashboard displaying the course syllabus. So let's create a new tab and call it Course Syllabus. We can use our primary content viewing app, 3D Play, add it to this tab by dragging and dropping, and then we can drag and drop a PDF of the course syllabus from 3D Drive right into our new 3D Play widget. But maybe PDFs are a little outdated and you use Google Docs for your syllabus or other course information. In this case, you can simply use a web page reader app to host external web pages in the 3DEXPERIENCE platform. We could also use the Quick Links app to provide quick access to a multiplicity of external web pages. There are plenty of other useful tools in the Collaborative Business Innovator role that we'll find helpful in providing your class with information, and they're all pretty intuitive to figure out. Once our course dashboard is complete, we can go into the drop-down toolbar and use the user group that we just created to share it with the class. There are a few options for sharing a dashboard. But in order to ensure that your class sees any edits or updates you make to the dashboard, as well as making sure that your students don't change things in the dashboard on you, let's just use the Manage Members option. We can then add individual users or user groups here with different privileges. For this particular dashboard, we want only the instructor to have editing and sharing rights. So we will add the class as a reader, meaning that all they can do is see the dashboard. If we add the class as contributors, then they would have some more editing rights, but only owners have full editing and sharing rights on the dashboard. To recap, we just created a very simple course dashboard to start with. We added some course materials in 3D Drive, and we showed a couple other ways of displaying information, such as a syllabus or external web pages that your students might need to access. And in our next video, we'll be diving into using our collaboration tool, 3D Swim, in the context of the classroom.